Okie dokie. Should have everything going all right. Let me put him away so I can start working on the non-blank head. This is the blank one, but I've already got a base of sort of white face paint on a different head to work on, so let me get some of this stuff out of the way. So we can get going. Because I am excited to have this head done. And let's see. Let me pull chat up real quick. Okay. Got that up. Put some water in my jar. So this is what we're starting with. It's just some white gouache. Airbrushed on and some white pastel. There looks like there's a couple of little dust particles I gotta try to carefully remove. I might end up doing this off camera just 'cause like I do this better being real close to it. Though I don't think it's out of character if Cozy had a not perfect white face. That seems fitting to me. The couple of little things left won't be noticeable at all once he has makeup and stuff done. Last time, I also started a little painting to sort of plan out how things were going to go. I might work on that like off camera or as a whole separate endeavor, but the base watercolor is done. I also need to pull up reference pictures. I have not stared at Cozy's face as much as I have Mana's. Which, honestly, when I was doing Mana's face up, I learned a ton. There was stuff that I hadn't noticed before, and I'm sure there'll be things that I hadn't noticed before with this too. He also like changes the kind of makeup that he does sometimes, so I'm just gonna kind of pick which pieces I like best, I think. So much dust. All right, so I think we're gonna start with red and blue. It's not that kind of blue, it's more of a teal color. Yeah, kind of a little bit of that, but. Maybe a little bit darker. Maybe we'll double dip. Yeah. And the pastel probably won't really get seen a whole lot anyway, because I'm gonna add glitter and stuff on it too. Oh, we'll see how it goes. Grab some brushes. I tend to like to use just like, for the pastel part, I just use makeup brushes. Because they tend to be small and they're good with powder stuff, you know? So, the makeup he ends up doing is very sort of drag. And I'll see if I can zoom in here. It's a digital zoom, but I can't really move the camera anymore. So we'll see how that does. There we go, I think that's a little bit better. All right, so he's got some blue going on the crease. His face is always kind of, the side of his makeup is always kind of covered up with feathers, so I'm just gonna have to kind of guess at it. I also need a paper towel. So I can wipe off excess. It's probably going to take a few layers to get it looking more how I like, but that's okay. It seems he also went sort of into the tear area a little bit. There's also kind of some sculpting that goes on here too, 'cause, you know, obviously the doll doesn't look exactly like the person, so you're not just trying to emulate the makeup style they did. Let's see if we can get the other side. This is my own personal doll, so I'm not wearing gloves. There's also eyeliner to do after this, too. And all of his photos are really whited out, so it's kind of hard to tell what exactly is going on. Looks like the sealant got weird in a spot. It's okay. We might be able to work around it. We'll see. This red pastel is so pigmented. It's good though. Just wish it hadn't been weird in that one spot. I think the eyebrow will cover that though, so it won't be so awful. Blend, 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 and then blend more. think maybe some a melamine sponge will help too. I feel like this face up's really gonna become a lot more whenever I end up doing the liner. It's gonna be kind of awful looking until the liner happens. see. It looks more, way more bright on camera than it is in person. He definitely overdrew his lips for this. There's going to be a lot of glitter integrated into this too, so. But it's good to have a color base. I think he does have the tiniest bit of blush too. We'll use this more peachy kind of blush, I think. Just a tiny bit. I think it's time for a little bit of sealant. I'll swap to a little bit better of a camera. I'm actually going to mute here. Okay. That the right one? Yes. All right. Now we're getting to the more nerve-wracking part. But first, let's see if we can make this blue more blue. As much as I really want to fill the blue with glitter, he doesn't wear glitter in the crease, so. Unless we go into full whatever mode, we're not gonna do that. But if things get messed up where we gotta start over, that might be an experiment. We see how it goes. But I am enjoying how much more blue this is now. Which is not surprising. Oh, sorry, let me change cameras. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with his teeth. Oh, hi, Seven. My kitten decided to join me. Sweet lady. Oh wow, that is like really stark red now. Wow, that is vibrant. Certainly brings it to a whole other level. Makes it seem much more intentional. Which is a good thing. Yep. I can't believe that's just two layers. It's kind of crazy. I think I might have messed up the lips, but oh well. This is a very specific face up that I haven't done before, so I wasn't exactly expecting to get it right on the first try. Maybe a kneaded eraser can save us. I think my fingernail messed up his white nose paint. Dang it. Right, well, we'll just keep going and see how it turns out, but I think we're heading downhill. That is okay. Can't decide if I should do line work or glitter. Glitter sounds more fun, but I think I should do line work. So he's got an outline around his lips. And we're going to be filling in part of this with glitter, so. And he doesn't actually do it real perfectly anyway. And we can wipe away parts we don't like. Oh, hello. I made these head sticks. This is version 2.0 of the head sticks. I've got a whole kind of drying system that I use. Because I used to do kind of assembly line sort of stuff. Pretty much feel like I have completely messed this face up, so I'm probably gonna start over. But I'm just taking the opportunity to play and learn. But who knows? We'll see. I've got to cover up parts of this with glitter, so maybe the glitter will save the day. We'll see. Yeah, they're really great because you could just hold them and turn them as you and do different, you know, angles so you make sure you get all the nooks and crannies. And I've got a little stand that they go in. So I used to have a custom built wall stand I made that I could stick them into, but I don't use that anymore. I'm also really out of practice for doing face-ups generally. Please don't judge my line work too awfully. Yeah, I got my little spray booth right here that I spray into. I might even just have him keep this face up for a little bit. Just see how I feel about it. It'll be just nice to have some paint on his face. This has been a long-running project. Yep, this is ruined. That's okay. I could probably wipe it off and redo it, but oh, yeah, I've had people ask for it, and I want to. I gotta do it. I really need to get all my digital stuff sort of in order so I've got room for the video files to be able to edit and stuff. That's really kind of the main thing stopping me. But I started working on it. Slowly but surely. I do want to do one though, because I really like my craft space, and I feel like people would enjoy seeing it and might get some good ideas. Always much better at doing this side rather than this side of the face. Oh, yeah. Yeah, because I have a pretty dreamy little setup. Well, now that we have thoroughly messed that up, I'm just gonna do glitter. Really thought about how I want to hold the glitter on. I think I'm gonna use the Zukimura clear stuff. Maybe? Yeah, let's try it. It's what I've used other times, so it just takes a while to dry. But it works really well. My sort of junk brush for doing this. Don't know where he went. Nope. Maybe I left it in the bathroom to dry? Let's see. Nope. I know it's somewhere, I just don't see it. There's a bunch of other brushes I could grab to use. I just like using that other one. Well, I choose you, Pikachu. Maybe I ruined it in a previous session. I had to get rid of it. I don't know. Okay, that should be enough. I think I'm gonna start with the lips because they are the most annoying. To this. So I think I'm gonna start with this really fine glitter and then do some bigger holographic glitter after. Now the real trick will be doing this and not spilling glitter everywhere. Sorry if I keep getting out of the camera for this. The people that have done, like, really great YouTube videos where, like, it's always a really great angle for watching how they do something, like, that blows my mind. I have to end up holding my stuff in all kinds of crazy directions. Also, by the way, if you're coming into this late, I already consider this a failed face up, so don't judge it too harshly. I'm playing around with mediums I've not really used together, and I'm also just really rusty. It's been a long time since I've done this type of stuff, so I'm just kind of playing at this point. I don't quite have all of the glitter that I wish I had for this, but we're gonna see if the combinations of what I got work out well enough. And his mouth is open too, so like I'm not sure what I'll do about that next time. I mean, the glitter might be distracting enough where it'll be okay, I guess. And I did want to see if I could use some of this glitter. this because it's like holographic, but he's definitely getting like gummy lips now. There's too much going on. That's okay. I think for the eyes, I'm going to try to mix the glitter into the gloss. Hello. Oh, thanks. It's definitely gonna get wiped, but I'm just playing for now. The side that you are seeing at the moment is definitely the better side. The other side I had messed up in a couple places and just kinda had given up at that point. But I wanted to keep playing and try out some different techniques, because some of this is brand new to me. I really should have sealed it before I started doing this, but it's okay. Hopefully, stuff doesn't run too much. Who knows? Maybe the glitter will be distracting enough. Oh, sorry, I'm totally out of camera. Alright, let's see where we get now. This side is definitely awful. The other side's pretty good, though. I'm not too angry about it. have thought glitter is actually difficult to work with when you're trying to be this detailed and stuff so tiny. This is going to be a really difficult face-up to get just right. Yeah. He's supposed to have like jewels and stuff glued on him, but I think I'm gonna not do it since I'll definitely be redoing this face up. But I am gonna seal him and gloss him and kinda leave him in it for a bit to consider what I'll do differently next time. I know Mana's face up is kind of from multiple different sessions, sort of. I didn't do a full wipe, but definitely will do a full wipe for this one. I'll have to. So, yeah. I'm gonna mute so I can spray and it won't be super loud for anybody. Okay. I know I can never really super trust the number of people that YouTube tells me is on here. But if anyone wants to see the stuff I have left over from Swap, I'm happy to take a camera over and show that stuff. 'Cause I would love for it to find a home that's not my house. Maybe I'll do a whole separate, better titled video stream for that. That way, it's easier to reference and whatnot. Cleaning up glitter is my favorite. You think you got it all, and then you find some more. Like the sand of the art world. Right, I think I'm gonna paint on a little bit more of the clear stuff and then leave them to dry for a little while. Probably not really waiting as long as I should for this, but don't incredibly care. I mean, it's not completely unfitting. The person I'm basing this off of definitely seems like they would be real messy about this. Oh, sealant had not finished doing its thing. Ooh. We'll see how this dries. are two little pieces of glitter I want to not be there. Got it. All right, let's let this monstrosity dry. It's looking pretty awful. All right. Well, thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you guys later. I might do a different stream of all the stuff that needs to be adopted.